Our old parents, they eat everything they want to eat.
Yes.
They swim now. We do tablets with them. All those delicious food we used to eat. We can't eat it again. Someone said, I said, if you keep on eating, yes, go to die. He said, let me die with that. I'm not going to. That you still, if you keep on eating certain food with them, say, I said, you're not eating. Praise God. They said that there will people is going to be on record that what I love most. That's what take me home. Hallelujah. Praise God. Oh my, are you getting something? It's not that I will laugh. No, I want you to gain something. He's going to bless you. The blessing of God, that's what we need. The blessing that you make. There are some people outside there that we need to help. Bible says it's going to make you a blessing to other people. Let me tell you, I thought God may make you to experience lack. So that when you get the blessing, you know how to use it. It will make you to go through sickness and diseases. So when you get out of it, you know how to heal the sick. There was a day I was asking God, any assignment God has given to you, it will make you to experience it yourself. When a vision was given to me, everyone of you knows, Isaiah 61, 1 to 6. And said, the spirit of the living God is upon me to heal the brokenhearted and to set the captive to those. I said, my heart is not broken. I know I was at the preliminary. You have to graduate from school of suffering before you can go to the next level. The school of suffering is the ladder that will take you to the highest height. Go and read the Bible. There is no one that experienced the best supernatural breakthrough. Do you want to talk about Abraham? Do you want to talk about Moses that was in the wilderness? There are all the friends you know how to say is the trees. Do you want to talk about Jacob that was deceived? That the journey of 7 years become of 14 years. The wife he lost to marry, they gave him the wrong wife. Hello? Do you want to talk about Hannah? That Israel and rival has to bring her to her knees. If you have child, you know how to treat people's children. Tell me someone that was successful in the Bible that did not go through anything. And who are you? Just want to fly. All those things that you are going through is a ladder to take you forward.
Amen.
Then to live a divine head is from God too. Exodus 23, 25 to 26. God is taking you somewhere in the name of Jesus Christ. Worship the Lord your God, and his blessing will be on your food and water. What blessing will be on your food? God's blessing. You will eat food and you say, God, I just sent you. Let me tell you, it's not how expensive the food is that will make you, that will grant you satisfaction. You can take a nice sandwich and still be okay. And I will tell you, just go to Red Lobster and go there and say, it's just tasteless. It's not about the food, it's about you. If your mind is not settled, there's no food you eat that you enjoy it. But when your mind is settled, you can just go to McDonald's and say, oh, this food is good today. That's why when they give food to the sick, they don't enjoy it. It's people that knows them enjoy the food. Jeremiah 8:19-22. The blessing of the Lord is made available to you today.
Amen.
Amen. The balm of Gilead is still available to you.
Amen.
To heal you of every sickness and diseases. And I stand on that platform of the Most High God today. And declare every sickness and diseases that you are going through right now, I declare supernatural healing in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare supernatural healing in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare the healing of God to be manifested. He was despised and rejected by men. A man of sorrows and familiar with suffering. And what happens? He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wound we are what? Healed. How many of you is going to be healed this morning? Say, I am healed in the name of Jesus Christ. The healing of God is your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, God is going to move you from the graveyard this morning. Financial graveyard, spiritual graveyard, emotional graveyard, and it's going to take you to a new level, a new realm. God is going to, how many of you is going to experience divine appointment this morning? I took in the morning service, there was a woman, a man in the Bible, with two sisters. And they lived together happily. At times, Jesus Christ visited them and stayed with them.